Hello, beautiful humans. Thank you so much for joining me today. My name is Jenny. This is a core and restore class. For this class, I don't have any props specifically that we're going to use, but when we do get into the restore part, if you have blocks, bolsters, blankets, cushions, anything that you want to use to support yourself, I'll give some direction on how to do that. And if you practice regularly with blocks or a strap, feel free to grab those. Today we're going to be focusing on, of course, building core strength, but how that can relate to balance. And so we'll be doing some standing balancing poses, really engaging in that core, getting a good workout in, and then we'll chill out with a nice restore. So thank you so much for joining me today. Let's jump right in. We'll start in a comfortable seated position. So whatever that looks like for you. I like to sit up on a blanket or even on a block. It just helps to give a little lift to the booty so you can tilt the pelvis forward and sit a little bit taller. That's really helpful if you have tight hips or low back and you notice when you sit, you kind of have to lean back or round out. That little lift just helps to bring a little more extension so you can sit just a little bit taller. You're welcome to have the legs crossed. They could extend out in front of you. You could even draw the knees in towards the chest. So take some time to get any wiggles out, to settle in. Feel free to let a nice sigh out of the mouth. As you just start to settle in, starting to become aware of your environment, aware of your present moment. Maybe noticing the sounds outside, maybe the sounds inside, noticing any sights or smells. Just really starting to get oriented with your space, with your present moment. And sometimes our external environment can feel very chaotic, and as we try to settle into our yoga practice, that could be one thing that's pulling our attention away from us. So we don't want to try to ignore or bypass anything. We really want to try to accept things as they are, even maybe little annoyances or background noises that are pulling away our attention, and just allow all of it to be a part of the process. It's also a good little practice in understanding that we don't have any control over what happens outside of us. We simply have control over how we react to that. And once you start to feel nice and oriented with your external environment, start to draw that awareness inward, starting to check in with your internal environment, which may feel more chaotic than the external. Start to feel into the body, noticing any aches or pains, any areas of tension or tenderness. Acknowledging and holding space for any injuries, acute or chronic. Checking in with your emotions, how you're feeling, where you're feeling it. Checking in with your energetic levels. And again, accepting things as they are, accepting yourself as you are right now in this moment. The good, the bad, the ugly, accepting it all. Working with what you got. Start to notice your breath. And if you'd like, start to bring in a little audible quality to the breath. Drawing the breath in and out of the nose and creating a little oceanic sound by engaging the muscles in the back of the throat. Gives you that whisper breath or the Darth Vader breath. A little ujjayi breathing. And continue to connect to the breath, use it to explore the body. And we want to try to maintain this presence and the breath throughout our practice. We will be doing some moves that may feel a little more like a workout, I like to call gym rat yoga. And really, you can turn any movement, any activity into a physical practice of yoga. It doesn't have to be the traditional poses when you bring awareness and breath into it. And we want to use the breath to facilitate the movement. So let's start to add in a little gentle movement, linking it to the breath just to get used to that pattern. So start to release the arms down alongside the body. Sitting up nice and tall on an inhale, send the arms out to the side, start to reach them up towards the sky. And on an exhale, release the right hand down, reach up and over through the left fingertips as you arch over. Inhale, come back up through center, both arms reach up towards the sky. Exhale, release the left hand down as you reach the right fingertips up and over, find a side stretch. And we'll repeat here, side to side, inhale to come up through center. Exhale to arch it over, keeping the sits bones grounded, knees are heavy. Inhale, come back up through center. And exhale, take it to the other side. We'll take a few more rounds like this. Link the breath to the movement. Use the full inhale to come up through center. And the full exhale to release all the way over to the side. A few more rounds like this. Starting to find a little engagement in the obliques. Around. When you're ready, inhale back up through center, reaching both arms up. Exhale, nice gentle twist over towards the right. Inhale back up through center, both arms reach up towards the sky. And exhale, gentle twist to the left. Inhale back up through center, and this is where we'll repeat. Exhaling to twist, nothing forceful, nothing aggressive, just kind of letting the hands drape down. Inhale, back up through center, again using those core muscles. Exhale to the twist. Really focus on that movement coming from your core. Last round, one to each side. Inhale to center. Exhale, twisting. Inhale back through center. And exhale, twist the other side. Awesome work. Inhale back up through center. Exhale, we'll bring the hands forward. Spread out through the hands. The arms are parallel to the ground. Spread out and then draw the fingers back. Really spread out through the hands, get some activation there, and then draw the fingers back, starting to get a stretch through the wrist, through the forearm. Awesome work. We'll take this a little bit further. Bring the right hand over towards the left fingers and gently start to draw back, just creating a little more stretch here. Awesome work. Release the fingers and then turn the fingers down towards the ground so the palm is facing you. And just spread out, find that stretch as you draw the fingers back. And then if you'd like to take it a little further, again, bring in that right hand, gently draw it back, getting a nice stretch through the tops of the hand, the wrist, and up into the forearm. Excellent work. Then we'll switch it out. Spread out through the fingers in the right hand and then draw the fingers up, pressing through the palm. And then if you'd like a little bit more, bringing that left hand in to draw the fingers back, getting a little deeper stretch through the body. bottom side of the wrist into the hand, maybe even into the back of the wrist. Awesome work. Then when you're ready, release the hand, spread them out, and then start to turn the fingertips down. Still spreading out through the hand, nice and active. Arm is parallel. And then if you want a little bit more, again, bringing in that left hand to draw the fingers back. Awesome work. Nice little stretching for the wrists and forearms. Release it and just shake it out. Maybe roll out through the wrists. Awesome work. Now we're going to start to come forward to hands and knees, so setting up a tabletop. You can remove any props that you were sitting on. You can set up the shoulders directly, the wrists directly underneath the shoulders, but if it feels better for that curvature in the wrist, walk the hands forward. Spread them out. Draw the belly in, extend through the spine, extend out through the tailbone, and then we'll bring in some cat-cow. Inhaling to lower the belly, pelvis tilts up, gaze lifts, heart shines forward. Exhale, round it out, belly draws in and up, tuck the chin, tuck the toe. Take a few more rounds like this, finding some nice spinal flexion, nice stretch for the front and back bodies. Warmed up with some nice side stretching. Now just getting the front and back of the torso. Awesome work. Now just a little more stretching for the wrists. With the fingers spread out nice and wide, just start to shift the shoulders either over the wrist a little bit forward. If that's too much, feel free to walk the knees forward so you can kind of play with the amount of weight you're putting on the wrist, but just a little deeper stretch here. All right, maybe shake it out. And the reason we're doing so many wrist warm-ups is because we are getting into some planks. So when you're ready, we're gonna spread out through the hands, start to step the feet back. You can prop the toes, lift the knees, finding your plank. You're also welcome to lower the knees down. Whichever option you're taking, you wanna keep a nice diagonal with the spine. So if I were to take maybe a marble from the top of my head, it would roll all the way down diagonally, either down to my knees or down to the heels. Core is engaged, press the ground away. Fantastic work. Belly draws in and up. Find your breath. All right, now working a little bit of balance here. We're going to raise the right foot up, coming into a three-legged dog. You could still do this with that left leg lowered as you hover that right foot. Keep the right foot active. Awesome work. One more deep inhale. Maybe raise it a little higher. Exhale, lower it down. Switch it out. Inhale, raise that left foot up. So we're balancing between the arms and the right leg. We're finding that engagement in the core, lengthening through the spine, finding your breath. Awesome work. Inhale, raise that foot just a little higher. Exhale, lower it down. We're gonna pick up the pace. Inhale, right foot up. Exhale, lower. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, lower. Inhale, right. Exhale, lower. Inhale, left. Exhale, lower. Last one. Inhale, right. Exhale, lower. Inhale, left. Exhale, lower. One more deep round of breath here. Feeling that shaking in the arms. And then inhale, lift the hips. Start to find a downward dog. The chest comes back towards the thighs. Press into the hands as you lengthen through the spine. And then you can pedal through the feet. Shake the head, yes or no. Awesome work. When you're ready, look up at the hands and start to walk the feet forward. You can keep a bend in the knees, coming towards a forward fold. Inhale, find a half lift. Lengthen through the spine. Hands can come to the shins or to the thighs. Find this engagement here. We're lengthening that tailbone back. There's a slight bend in the knees. And then if you'd like to take it a little bit further, extend the hands back behind you, palms facing down, spread out through the hands. We're lengthening through the spine, core is engaged. Fantastic work. One more deep round of breath. When you're ready, on an inhale, we're gonna swim the hands forward and up as we lift the heels up, coming into balancing chair. If that's a little too much, you can leave the heels down. If it doesn't feel good to have the arms extended, bring them into goalposts. They could come to the hips. Awesome work. So we're in flying chair here. Knees are drawing together, core is engaged, spine is lengthening. Now we're gonna we're gonna play with some balance here. So we're gonna inhale, lift the right knee up. Exhale, lower down, it's a challenge. Inhale, left knee up. Exhale, down. You can lower the heels down if that's a little too much. Inhale, right knee up. Exhale, lower. Really use those core muscles. Use that hip flexor to lift that knee up and back down. Awesome work, right knee up and down. We're keeping that bend in the knees. Inhale, left knee up and back down. Inhale, right, back down. Last one, left and down. Awesome work, we're still bending low. Maybe go a little bit lower into your chair pose. Maybe arms extend if they're not already there. Awesome work. On your next inhale, we're gonna come to standing, but lift that right knee up. Nice work. Find that balance, active in the feet. Now nice and slow, trying to not use momentum. We're gonna slowly start to step that foot back to a low lunge. Trust yourself, trust the ground will be there. Awesome work. Feel that stretch. That back leg is extending, back leg is active. The hands could be forward as you hover the chest, or you could work towards a gentle back bend. Just keep aware if the ribs are splaying open, draw them in. Nice work. One more deep inhale here. Exhale, release the hands down. Find blocks or the ground, and then we'll start to straighten through that front leg. You can keep the legs wide if that feels good, or you could step the foot in to plant that back foot down, finding pyramid. Nice stretch for the backs of the legs. Right hip drawing back, left hip shifting forward, release the head down. Fantastic work. When you're ready, on an inhale, we're gonna start to shift the weight forward. We're gonna kick that back leg up, coming into a one-legged forward fold. Keep that right foot active, toes flexed or pointed, head releasing down. Feel free to stay here, or if you wanna play a little more with balance, find warrior three. You could start to hover the chest, hands could stay on the ground, they could come to the thigh, to the shin, they could come to prayer, or they could extend. Fantastic work. Now just like we came into that lunge, we're slowly going to raise up. We're gonna draw that right knee back up, really working that balance, engage in the core. Nice work. And when you're ready, set the foot down. Inhale, lengthen up, exhale, prayer hands, heart center. Awesome work, find your breath. All right, three rounds of chair, so when you're ready, inhale, scoop the arms up towards the sky. Exhale, bend the knees, send the hips back. Inhale, raise back up. Exhale, bend and lower. Awesome work. One more. Inhale, straight through the legs. Arms reach up. And exhale, bend the knees. Back to chair. Awesome work. Pause here. Find that strength in the legs, engage in the core. All right, when you're ready, on your next inhale, we're coming up to standing, but we're bringing that left knee up with us. Active through those left toes. Ground down to that right foot. Find that connection to all four corners, really working those stabilizing muscles. Find engagement in the core. The more you engage the core, the more core strength you build, the better it is for your balance. All right, when you're ready, we're gonna start to send that leg back. Trusting that the ground will be there as we come to our lunge. And ending in high crescent lunge. Find that activation in that back leg. Hips are squared. Find whatever angle works for the spine. Chest hovering, arms extending. We're up towards a gentle back bend, ribs hugging in. Fantastic work. Embrace that shaking in the legs if you got it. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, release the hands down. Bring the hands to frame the foot. Again, you can bring blocks or books in to bring the ground closer. We'll start to straighten through the front leg. Root that back heel down. Or if you'd like to shorten the stance, bring that back foot in till you can plant the foot on the ground. Release the head, neck, and shoulders down. Find your breath. Awesome work. When you're ready, we're gonna start to shift that weight forward and we're gonna kick the back leg up. So we're coming into our one-legged forward fold. Keep those left toes active, either flexed or pointed. And it doesn't matter if the toes are just barely hovering off the ground or if the leg is parallel or if it's sticking all the way up into full splits. Work with what you got. Awesome work. From here, we're going to half lift. So we're going to lift the chest up and we're going to play with warrior three. So you're welcome to stay here with the hands on the ground or blocks. They could come up to the shin or to the knee for support. They could come to prayer. They could extend out. They could even fly back. Awesome work. And we're rooting down towards that right foot, working those stabilizers. Left leg is active. And then nice and slow, we're gonna start to bend that left knee as we come through standing pose, drawing that knee back up towards center. Inhale, reach it up, and exhale, step the foot down, bring hands down to heart center. Find your breath. Fantastic work. All right. Here we go. Inhale, scoop the arms back up towards the sky. Exhale, bend the knees, come to chair pose. Then bring the hands down to heart center. Awesome work. Now this one, again, working the balance, but bring engagement in the core. Move from those core muscles. So you can do it from flat feet or from our flying Brit or flying chair with the heels raised. We're going to lift the right knee. Step it out to the side, just a little tap. Bring the knee back in, and then lower down. And we're gonna switch it out. Right, excuse me, left knee up. Step it out to the side, just a little tap. Bring the knee back in towards the chest, and then set it down. Inhale, knee up. Exhale, step it out. Inhale, draw the knee back in. Exhale, step it down. Awesome work. Inhale, left knee up. Exhale, step it out to the side, just a little tap. Inhale, use those muscles to bring the knee back up. Exhale, step it down. Inhale, left, excuse me, right knee up. Exhale, step it to the side. Inhale, back up through center. Exhale, down. One more, inhale, left knee up. Exhale, step it to the side. Inhale, back up through center. Exhale, step it down. Inhale, scoop the arms up towards the sky. And exhale, dive forward, forward fold. Awesome work. Inhale, halfway lift, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, fold it in, plant the hands on the ground. Step the feet back to plank.
Again, we're either in full plank or half plank. Both are building up strength in the core, pressing the ground away. And we've got a little tilt of the hip bones up towards the sternum. So we're kind of drawing in that way. That also helps to bring some length to the tailbone. So you can see I'm not dropping my hips down and arching through the back. I'm drawing everything in and up. Fantastic work. When you're ready, on an exhale, lower down either to a push-up or all the way to the belly. Inhale, come up to cobra or upward dog. And exhale, send it back, downward dog. Fantastic work. Find your breath. Whew. I am sweaty. I don't know if it's the talking and the doing, but I feel like I sweat even more in these live classes. Awesome work. A few more rounds of breath in our down dog. Really find that lift of the hips from the belly. So the belly is drawing in and up, ribs are hugging in. That's helping to bring those hips up towards the sky. Lengthening through the spine. We don't want to round out in the spine. We want it nice and straight. And if you need to bend in the knees to get that length in the spine, feel free. All right, awesome work. When you're ready, we're gonna look up at the hands and we're gonna walk the feet forward until we come to a seat. So we're gonna come all the way down to the ground. Legs extend out. Once again, find that solid connection to the sits bones. Maybe move any flesh that may be there. And then extend out through the arms. Sit up nice and tall. And then exhale slowly, one vertebra at a time, rounding out. Make your way down to the ground. So make sure you have space back behind you. Really slow, pressing the low back into the mat. Eventually the mid back, the low ribs, the shoulder blades, the shoulders, and last the head. Send the arms overhead. Find a nice big good morning stretch. Roll out through the wrists and ankles, wiggle through the fingers, spread out through the toes. All right, when you're ready, draw the knees in towards the chest, one at a time or simultaneously. Bring a little tuck through the tailbone, lengthen through the spine. Maybe grabbing onto the knees and rocking side to side or circling through the knees, giving yourself a little back massage. All right. If you're not already a sweaty mess like me, we're gonna get there. So we're gonna do, this is a Pilates move. It's called the 100, and we're gonna add breath of fire. So we've done this before in a few other videos, but breath of fire, or fire breath, is a very active exhale as you draw the belly in really tight, and then a very passive inhale, and the belly just kind of releases. So before, I'll show a quick little demonstration. So it's a really quick inhale, really active exhale, passive inhale, so it's like this. And it's kind of hard to see the belly, but the belly really draws in on that exhale, and then as it releases, it just kind of pops out. So it's okay to get a little gut going with this one. So that's the breath we're going to be doing. If you have allergies like me, you may need to blow your nose first. But what we're going to do is extend the legs up towards the sky, flex the toes back. Legs could stay like this, or for more of a challenge, they could start to lower down at an angle. Don't bring them down so low that the low back starts to raise up off the ground. We're going to extend the arms out, but if you find that that doesn't, if you need support for the neck and shoulders, you can bring the hands back behind you. We're going to inhale to raise the head, neck, and shoulders up off the ground. And then we're going to bring in pumping with the arms that will help to bring in that fire breath. So here we go.
Keep going. Keep that belly active. It's going to start getting really challenging here. Keep it going. Embrace the shake. Flex through the toes. Keep rooting out through those heels. Nice and active. Head, neck, and shoulders lifting off the ground. Just a few more rounds. 10 more. Last one, little all the way out. As you draw the knees in, hug them in, release the head and neck down. Whew. I don't know about you, but I am feeling that in the belly. Awesome work. All right. Now we're going to bring in kind of a similar movement, but we're going to kind of swim it up and without the fire breath. So we're going to extend the legs out once again, just kind of finding what works for you. Maybe even bringing the legs a little lower because we're going to be swimming, so like kicking the legs. So this may be enough for you. You may want to raise the head, neck, and shoulders up off the ground. For a real challenge, we'll see if I can even do this. I've been working on this one. You can start to raise the upper body up and then back down. So we can call this maybe like a swimming boat. So you can stay down low or you could bring it up and back down. Awesome work. Really work that core. So lots of different levels. So bring in that breath. And if the legs need to be higher up, kicking like that, the knees could even be bent. We want to really protect that low back. Awesome work. One more round of breath. And release. Knees back in towards the chest. Whoo-wee. I'm feeling that one. Awesome work. Now, since we just did all that core work, let's bring in a little stretching for it, bringing in a bridge pose. So we're going to plant the feet on the ground. Knees hip distance, legs parallel. Walk the heels in towards the glutes. And then we'll bring a puffing up of the chest, really exaggerating that arch in the low back or in the mid back as you tuck the shoulder blades underneath. And then really ground down towards the feet. Lift through the toes, spread them out, and then set them down so you have that full awareness of the feet. Press into the feet, into the shoulders. Inhale, lift the hips up to bridge pose. Coming up as high as feels okay. If you'd like, you could tuck the shoulders underneath even more, interlacing the hands at the low back, bringing in a little more lift. If you want something a little more passive here, you could slide a block, a bolster, stack of books, stack of pillows underneath the hips for a supported bridge. It's getting a nice stretch for those core muscles we were working, nice stretch for the hip flexors, and working with a little back bending. Core work can sometimes not be so fun, but it's one of the best things that you can do for your body, especially if you have back pain. Of course, speak to your doctor first, but a strong core can really help with back pain. Awesome work. A few more rounds here. And if you want a little more challenge here, again, you can make this as active or as passive as you want. If you want a little more active, inhale, extend the right leg up towards the sky. Exhale, start to lower it halfway down till it's parallel to the ground, legs straight. Inhale, raise it back up. Exhale, lower it down. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, lower right leg parallel to the ground. Inhale, raise it up. Exhale, step the right foot down, switch it out. Inhale, left leg extends. Exhale, lower that leg down till it hovers.
parallel.
Inhale, raise it up. Exhale, lower it down. Last round if you want it. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, left leg down. Inhale, raise it up. Exhale, bend the knee, step the left foot down. One more deep inhale, lift the hips. If you have a prop there, slide it out. Unclasp the hands if they're clasped, untuck through the shoulders. And on an exhale, slowly lower down. One vertebrae at a time. Nice work, step the feet out a little wider than hip distance. Drop the knees over towards the right. Back up through center, over towards the left. A few rounds of windshield wipers. Maybe the arms come out into a T or reach overhead or anything else that would feel really awesome. Awesome work. When you're ready, knees back towards center, draw the knees in towards the chest. We'll take a happy baby. Knees out wide, toes flexed back, feet up towards the ceiling, knees towards the armpits. You can grab on behind the knees, on the outsides of the legs, or up on the feet. You can chill here. You can use the hands to continue to draw the knees down towards the ground as you lengthen out through the tailbone. You could also kick out through the legs, maybe one side, then the other, whatever feels right here. Fantastic work. When you're ready, we'll release the feet down. Knees bent, and then we'll draw the right knee in towards the chest. Left leg could stay where it is, or you could extend that left leg out along the ground. And then using the hands on that right knee, just start to circle the knee around, using the top of the femur to get a little hip massage, a massage for the hip flexors, a little stretching there. All right, now we're gonna come into a half happy baby. So that same movement we just did, but just with that right leg. So right toes flexed back, foot up towards the ceiling, knee bent, knee drawing in towards the armpit. Again, the hands could come behind the knee, up the leg, or maybe they reach for the foot. And that left leg can be extended out along the ground. That may be a little too intense for the hips. Or if you want to also have that left foot planted, that also adds a little more stability. So pick what works best for you. Fantastic. When you're ready, we're going to release the right foot. We'll bring the left hand to the right knee and gently guide the left or the right knee over towards the left side of the body. So starting to take a twist. And that left leg could be extended, the knee could be bent, you could bring the knees to stack, whatever version of a twist would feel good for you here. That right knee could come across and land on a stack of blankets, a bolster, blocks, to kind of facilitate a more gentle twist. That right arm could extend out towards the side. You could take the gaze over for a little deeper twist. Just find what works for you. Find your breath. Fantastic work. When you're ready, we'll start to draw the right knee back up towards center. If the left knee's bent, go ahead and extend it along the ground. We'll bring the right foot to the inside of the left leg as we drop that right knee open.
So we're taking a reclined tree pose, is what it looks like. So we've got that left leg extended, right knee bent, right foot along the inside of the left leg, getting a nice opening and stretch in the hips, the hip flexors, maybe feeling a bit in the quad, and the hands can be doing whatever would feel good. Out into a T, they could raise overhead. Allow that right knee to hang heavy, or if gravity is working a little too much, then you can also put a block underneath that knee for some support. Beautiful work. When you're ready, leaving that right knee where it is, and just noticing this different sensation here, we'll slowly start to draw the left knee in towards the chest. So just noticing how that switches up the stretch. Feel into it, find your breath. And then as you feel ready, we'll slowly start to draw that right knee up towards center, in towards the chest. Nice little reset here. If you want to hug the legs in, rock side to side, take circles, take anything that would feel good here between sides. And then as you feel ready, we're going to bring both hands to the left knee, releasing the right foot towards the ground. The knee could stay bent, or you could extend that right leg out, keeping all the toes flexed back so the feet are nice and active. And then we'll use the hands to circle that left femur bone, the top of the femur, around in the hip sockets. Little hip flexor massage. Awesome work. When you're ready, setting up our half happy baby on the left side. So left knee in towards the chest with the toes flexed back. That left foot comes up towards the ceiling. Hands can come behind the knee, up the leg, or on the foot. And that right leg could stay extended, or for more stability and a little less intensity in the hips, you can plant the foot, bending the knee. Your choice, find what works on this side. May not be the same as the other. Find your breath. As you start to feel ready, we'll release our half happy baby and we'll start to set up our twist. So your choice what you want that right leg to be doing, if you want it extending or bent, but we'll gently bring the right hand to the left knee and guide it over towards the right, finding whatever variation of a twist works for you on this side. Doesn't have to be the same exact twist that you took on the other side. Really listen to your body. Really adjust and, you know, modify as needed. I don't really like the term modification, because that implies that there is one right way to do something and then everything else are just adjustments to that one right thing. The right way for you to practice yoga is what feels best in your body. So a cue that, or an instruction that speaks to me and feels good in my body may not feel good in your body. And what feels good in your body may not feel good for me. So my goal as a teacher is to give you enough tools in your toolbox to be able to step on your mat either by yourself or
you know, with a video or in an actual class, and to be able to take the instructor's direction, but create your own practice. Let it be suggestions, and then you take what works for you and your body and work with that. Don't ever feel forced to get yourself into a position that just doesn't feel right. Your body will tell you. So never force anything. Awesome work. When you're ready, we'll start to slowly untwist. If that right knee was bent, go ahead and extend. And then we'll take that left knee all the way over towards the left, opening up into our reclined tree pose. And arms can be doing whatever you'd like. Feel into your body. And then as you feel ready, keeping the left knee where it is, slowly starting to draw the right knee in towards the chest, just noticing different sensation there. Right toes flexing back to stay nice and active. Nice and slow, as you feel ready, start to draw the left knee back up towards center. Start to bring it in towards the chest, and then again, just kind of reset. Maybe hugging the knees in or rocking side to side. You could take some circles through the knees. And as you feel ready, we'll take reclined cobbler's pose. So release the feet down towards the earth. Bring the bottoms of the feet to touch and let the knees drop open. You're welcome to slide a bolster or rolled up blankets or blocks underneath the knees for support. You could also lift the feet up off the ground with a prop underneath. That just kind of brings a little more gentleness to the hips and to the low back. And if this does cause low back pain, two things that you can kind of explore that are kind of opposite of each other, so maybe one will work for you. One thing that you can do is lift the hips, tilt the pelvis down, and really flatten out that low back, and then reopen through the knees so that you have a nice neutral low back. Or, like we did setting up our bridge pose, exaggerating that natural curvature of the lumbar spine, mid part of the back, the thoracic spine. Really exaggerating that arch, bringing a little activation in the mid back to draw some of that weight out of the low back. And you can also tuck through the shoulder blades. So two ways to kind of explore that. You're also welcome to use a prop underneath the back, underneath the spine, to get a little more opening in the heart. If you've done that before, you're welcome to incorporate that. Letting the knees open, and the hands can be doing whatever they'd like. They could be alongside the body, they could be stretched out, they could be overhead. They could be resting on the belly, on the heart. They could even wrap around the body if you feel like you need a little more containment, if you're feeling a little vulnerable today. But really just allow gravity to do the work here.
If you do have super open hips and you're feeling nothing in this sensation, then you probably don't need to work on opening the hips, on stretching and finding flexibility in the hips. You'd want to work on getting engagement. So while some of us are relaxing into this, letting gravity do the work, if you're not feeling anything, start to hover the knees a little bit, squeeze the feet together, and find a little activation. So it won't be as, you know, as restorative as a pose, but it's going to be better for your body. Because your body doesn't need those deep, long stretches. Your body needs to build up support around those hypermobile joints so that you don't exploit them and injure those joints.
Few more rounds of breath here. More rounds of breath here as you allow this openness in the hips, opening in the heart. Just feel, just be present to what comes up for you physically, mentally, emotionally. Notice any resistance in the body, notice any tension in the body. And then breathe into that tension. Breathe into that resistance. You feel ready. We'll bring the hands to the outsides of the thighs just to offer the hips a little assistance as we draw the knees together. And one last pose. I just want to do a little inversion. So if you'd like, just send the legs up towards the sky in a reclined pike pose. You could shake out through the legs, you could circle through the ankles. If you do want a little more, you could take this into a shoulder stance. By lifting the hips, hands to the low back, elbows come together. The weight is in the elbows, the shoulders, the triceps, no weight in the neck at all. The ankles could come in line with the hips and just kind of find that sweet spot where you can hang out here. Or again, maybe shake out through the legs, release some synovial fluids. You could roll out through the ankles, spread out through the toes. You could even explore with some larger movements. If it felt good on the low back, you could start to take the toes overhead like a pike pose, or excuse me, plow pose. But really, I'm just looking to get your legs above the heart. You're also welcome to set up some sort of support underneath the low back, like in bridge pose, putting a block there and then extending the legs up so that you're in a supported shoulder stance. Fantastic work. As you feel ready, if you are up in shoulder stance and want just a little more, release the hands down first, and then try to roll down one vertebrae at a time, nice and slow.
Nice work. We'll start a transition towards our shavasana, or our final relaxation, but if you want to take any time to explore any final movements, if there's anything you want to revisit or something that we didn't get to that would feel awesome in your body, feel free to explore that. When you're ready to set up your shavasana or your final relaxation, could be traditional corpse pose on the back, palms turned up, toes turned out. If being on the back doesn't feel awesome, lie on your side, lie on your belly. Take as much time as you'd like to start to settle in. And some people have questioned giving modifications in shavasana, you know, shouldn't it stay traditional? And my approach as a yoga teacher is to notice all of the time, well, one of my approaches, to notice how many times in my career I've said, that's not yoga, that's not yoga, when really it is. Like I said earlier, you can turn anything into the physical practice of yoga with breath and with presence. And yoga just asks that you are aware of the body, that you are aware of what is going on in that present moment. And if in shavasana, lying on your back does not feel good, does not feel like that's where you can be, where you can surrender, then why force it? Do what's right for you. And know that yoga is all around us. Yoga isn't just what we see on Instagram. It's not just the crazy poses with insane flexibility. If you have a body and you can still breathe, you can do yoga. It's all yoga. Surrender to your shavasana, to your final pose, whatever that looks like for you. Release the breath, release the body. And simply observe. Have more time to dedicate to your shavasana, feel free to pause this video and give yourself as much time as you can. I suggest at least 5 minutes, but upwards of 20 to even 30 minutes. Taking extra time for rest, for surrender, for simply being. Take a moment to check in. Are you noticing any differences from when you first stepped on your mat to now? Just noticing any shifts, changes, integrations, releases, acceptance, anything that may have come from your mindful practice. And
Gently start to bring some movements back into the body. If you are lying down and not already there, gently start to make your way onto the side body, pausing for a moment in a nurturing pose, pausing for a moment to give yourself thanks for giving yourself this gift, this time to move and breathe and feel and connect. And as you feel ready, gently making your way back up to a comfortable seat. I'll invite you to bring the hands to heart center or take any other meaningful gesture with the hands. Thank you so much for sharing your time, your energy, your home with me today. It's been my pleasure. I see you, I honor you, and I bow to you. Namaste.